defend himself here. Wolf Blitzer spoke with Donald Trump about not this comment, but other comments back in March, disparaging comments he made about women. Here's what he said then.
These politicians, I know them. They say far worse when they're in closed doors or where they're with a group of people that they trust. Nobody respects women more than I do. Nobody takes care of women, and they take care of me.
Yeah, the point he's making there, Tara, is that there are others who say things like this, much like the written statement that came out in the afternoon. Donald Trump's claim that Bill Clinton said things much worse to him on the golf course.
That doesn't make it okay. I've said this many times. We as conservatives went after Bill Clinton, and rightfully so, for what happened in the 90s. And anyone who tries to sit there and point fingers and say, yeah, but Bill Clinton did it, is a hypocrite. If you're excusing away Donald Trump's behavior, that doesn't, just because other people do it, doesn't make it okay. This is a very elementary school defense. And something else, just to put this in perspective.
Sure.
Women vote at a higher rate than men and have since the 1980s. Women make up 51% of the population. They voted at a 4% higher rate than men in 2008 and 2012, which translates to about 9.8 million more votes. This, if you want to just get down to brass tacks here, this is catastrophic for Donald Trump, because most women are going to look at this and be repulsed by it, as they should be. So to sit there and try to say that, oh, this is just men being men, that's casting aspersions on the majority of men who are good and decent men who would never speak that way about women, especially, you know, married women. It's just, this is not acceptable, and we should not be casting aside our character and our integrity and our standards for political expediency.
And
Maria, I'm going to give you 20 seconds and 20 to Scottie.
If this was an isolated incident, as inappropriate and inexcusable as it was, you know, it may be. But this is 30 years in the running. Let's not forget the disgusting things he said on Howard Stern earlier in his career, talking about what he would do to women, grading women's bodies, degrading them, in fact saying he doesn't respect women. And an AP report came out about how he was abusive to the women on The Apprentice. A Los Angeles Times story came out about how he wanted to fire hostesses in one of his resorts for not being pretty enough. Let's be very clear. This man is an irredeemable pervert and sexual predator.
Scottie, take
and our own Erin, our own Erin Burnett last night on air confirmed that a friend of hers was in fact in a situation like that in a boardroom where Donald Trump popped in Tic Tacs and kissed her without her consent. So there's your
Scottie,
example.
Scottie, you're the sole Trump supporter on the panel. I got to give you 20 seconds. Go ahead.
But to Tara's point, this is all about the female vote. And this is truly while it's wrong, it is a distraction. This morning, no woman woke up affected by these words. What they were affected by...
Are you kidding?
Sexual assault victim.
Can I finish, please, ladies?
Hold on.
Wow.
Ladies, please.
Hold on.
Please. What they are affected by is opening up their mail and finding out that their health insurance was canceled or their premiums were doubled.
Oh,
what they
Scottie,
are affected,
sweetie.
No, they are. The issues
Wake
that are
up.
Actually
right.
affecting
Sorry.
Women today, this has nothing to do with. This is just a demonization.
You are living in a
of
fantasy
the female
world.
We've got to wrap it here.
You're not doing your candidate any favors.
We've got to wrap it here. But I would argue that there,
so
were not, that there were more than women who were affected by those words.
Yes,
probably like
it doesn't affect all day-to-day
are affected.
Decent Americans were all affected.
Maria Cardona.